Good morning, children, and my dear friends. Today, I am going to start a new chapter, that is Chemical Thermodynamics, on the request of some of my students. Okay, I have taken this decision to start with the topic of Chemical Thermodynamics. I think you all know, this is Lalita Peri, the science teacher, and basically I teach chemistry. I like the subject chemistry, so I became a chemistry teacher. Okay, so today I am going to start a new chapter, that is Chemical Thermodynamics. Thermodynamics is a very vast chapter, very important and very big chapter. Okay, so in this chapter we are going to come across so many new terms. Okay, but the thing is, you will come across the same chapter in physics also. Okay, thermodynamics is present even in physics also. In physics also you have this, in chemistry also you have this. So in chemistry, what you are going to deal with? Okay, so in this chapter, this is a very very big chapter, you are going to deal with so many new important terms. So teaching the chapter in one or two videos is not at all possible. So I'll make the videos into parts so that you can understand the concept clearly, right? So let us have the topic of, start with the topic of chemical thermodynamics. And in this video, I'm going to tell you only about the introduction for chemical thermodynamics. Okay, only introduction part, right children? Okay, so chemical thermodynamics. Chemical thermodynamics. Okay, so here thermodynamics is actually a Greek word. Okay, thermos. The word thermos. Okay, thermos is a Greek word which stands for what? Heat energy. Thermal energy. You all know. Heat energy. Okay, and dynamics. Dynamics is a branch of physics which deals with motion of objects. You all have studied. Okay, from 9th class onwards, you are studying. Dynamics is a branch of physics which deals with what? Motion of objects. Which deals with cause of motion of objects. Not only with motion of objects. What is the cause for the motion of so and so object? An object is made to move. Then what made it to move from one place to another place? Okay, what is the cause for the movement of that object? Okay, so you are going to learn about the factors affecting the motion of that object. Okay, cause for motion of that object. Everything you will be learning in what? Dynamics. So dynamics is a branch of physics which deals with motion of objects. Okay, so thermodynamics, okay, which deals with what? Motion or flow. Here we are going to learn about thermodynamics. That means what? Flow of heat from one place to another place. Okay, so thermodynamics is a kind of branch of chemistry as well as physical chemistry, better we say. Okay, it's a branch of physical chemistry which deals with what? Which deals with motion of heat from one place to another place. Okay, so that is what you call it as thermodynamics. Okay, so what is the definition for thermodynamics? Definition for thermodynamics. It's a branch of physical chemistry. It's a branch of physical chemistry. Okay, it's a branch of physical chemistry which mainly deals with what? Deals with energy exchange. Okay, now energy changes that happens during any process. Okay, energy changes deals with what? Energy changes that happens during any process. Okay, that process may be a physical process or it can be a chemical process also. Okay, now physical or chemical process. Here in chemistry, we are learning about all chemical processes. So that's why we should keep a special name here, chemical thermodynamics. I am going to deal with what here? Chemical thermodynamics. Okay, because I just said you, it is dealt even in physics also, isn't it? So which deals with energy changes. I think you all already have learnt in your lower classes that every chemical reaction is associated with either loss of energy or with a gain of energy in the form of heat. Okay, every chemical reaction is associated with either release of energy or absorption of energy. Okay, so accordingly you have learnt exothermic and endothermic reactions. Okay, so during any chemical process when it is happening, okay, so what are the energy changes that are taking place during that process? Okay, we are going to learn about that in thermodynamics. Okay, what energy changes occurred during any chemical process? Okay, different chemical processes also we will be learning. Okay, during any chemical process, what energy changes takes place? Energy changes takes place in what way? And how much energy change will takes place? Everything you are going to deal with in thermodynamics. Okay, so here energy change can be in the form of, energy change can be in the form of heat. In the form of heat, it can be in the form of heat. Okay, please remember, and I request all of you to please make a note of what all your teachers says. Take a book and pen and please keep writing what your teachers say. Okay, so energy change can be in the form of what? It can be in the form of heat. Okay, or it can be in the form of work. Okay, now it can be in the form of work done, or it can be in the form of radiation also. Okay, how energy exchange takes place? How energy changes takes place? How exchange of energy takes place? Okay, it can be in the form of heat, transfer of heat, or transportation of heat from one form to another form. Okay, during the change of state of any substance. Please remember, thermodynamics deals with what? Energy changes, I said. Energy changes during what? During change of state, during any chemical process. In that chemical process, maybe it can undergo change of state. Okay, change of state means from what? From solid to liquid. Okay, or from liquid to gas. Okay, when any process is happening, when any interconversion is happening, some of the energy exchange will happen. That energy exchange can happen in the form of either heat or in the form of work. Heat, the energy can be transformed into another form either by exchange of heat or through work done or through radiation also. I think you have learnt how heat transfer takes place from one body to another body. In your lower classes, you have learnt conduction, convection and radiation, isn't it? These are the modes of heat transfer which we have learnt in our lower classes. Okay, so in this thermodynamics, we are going to learn how this energy exchange takes place. Okay, during the transformation of any substance from one state to another state, how much energy change is happening? How the energy change is happening? Okay, so all this we are going to learn in thermodynamics. Okay, so thermodynamics mainly deals with what? The energy changes that happens during any chemical process. Okay, so some important points we have to remember. Okay, please note down some important points. Thermodynamics is going to answer certain questions for us. Okay, what kind of questions it can answer for us? Okay, and what kind of things it will not deal with? Okay, both we will learn, right? सो थर्मोडायनेमिक्स कैन थर्मोडायनेमिक्स कैन आंसर सर्टेन क्वेश्चंस आंसर सर्टेन क्वेश्चंस लाइक दिस ओके वॉट काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस इट कैन आंसर फ्रॉम दिस वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड एक्चुअली वॉट दिस टॉपिक डील्स विथ इजंट इट सो इट कैन आंसर सर्टेन क्वेश्चंस लाइक वॉट ओके सपोज इफ टू और मोर सब्सटेंसेस आर पुट टुगेदर ओके if two or more substances are brought together okay then whether the reaction can happen or not okay that can be understood with the help of thermodynamics okay first question it can answer is whether the reaction can happen or not if two substances are brought together okay if two substances are brought together whether the reaction can happen or not okay the whether the reaction can happen or not can happen or not okay that means what this in other words you call it as what feasibility of the reaction okay feasibility of the reaction okay whether the reaction can happen or not it can tell thermodynamics can deal with that okay first thing is this one if two substances are brought together whether the reaction can happen or not whether the reaction is feasible or not that is the first thing it deals with and number 2 what is the second thing suppose if the reaction happens between them okay suppose if the reaction happens between them okay then at what concentrations of reactants and products okay the equilibrium will be established between them okay please understand the point carefully thermodynamics deals with feasibility of the reaction number 1 number 2 suppose if the reaction is feasible okay then at what concentrations of reactants and products okay now equilibrium will be established I think you all have learned about equilibrium what is chemical equilibrium if two substances if it is a reversible reaction okay the reaction in which reactants converts to products products converts to back to reactants you call it as what reversible reaction so in any reversible reactions okay equilibrium will be maintained what is equilibrium if the rate of forward reaction is equal to the rate of backward reaction the reaction is said to be under the system of reactions are said to be under equilibrium okay so at what concentrations the equilibrium will be established okay at what concentrations thermodynamics deals with number 2 is what at what concentrations of reactants and products at what concentrations of reactants and products equilibrium will be established okay at what concentrations of reactants and products equilibrium will be established okay equilibrium will be established at some point but at what concentrations will it be established you can say in thermodynamics if you know about thermodynamics you can say okay so that is second point okay can you able to understand I think please make a note of all these points right and at the same time as according to the definition what energy changes will occur number 3 it deals with what energy changes will occur what energy changes will occur during a reaction okay so these are the things which thermodynamics deals with it can deal with feasibility of a reaction It can deal with even the spontaneity of a reaction. How spontaneous the reaction, how spontaneously the reaction can take place. I think you have heard about spontaneous reactions. Okay, the reactions which can happen spontaneously. Okay, that also we'll be learning. When the reaction will be spontaneous, when it cannot be spontaneous. Okay, that all we are going to learn in this. Okay, it also deals with what? Can able to see, right? Spontaneity of the reaction also. Spontaneity of the reaction. Okay? Right? So these are the things which thermodynamics deals with. And it does not deals with what? Okay, it deals with these things. Then thermodynamics does not deal with what? Does not deal with rate of reaction. We'll write that points also, right? Thermodynamics does not deal with what? Thermodynamics does not deal with certain points, okay? Does not deal with rates of reactions. Does not deal with rates of reactions. I think you know that rates of reactions can be studied under chemical kinetics in another chapter. In another chapter, chemical kinetics, rates of reactions of certain chemical reactions can be known. Okay, with what rate, with what speed the reaction will take place. All that you will be learning under chemical kinetics, but not in thermodynamics. Okay, and thermodynamics always deals with bulk phenomenons only. Always deals with bulk properties only. But bulk properties means macroscopic properties. In some of the textbooks, this word macroscopic properties, but not with microscopic properties. Means what? Microscopic properties. Understand this point carefully. Bulk properties, that means whichever is the process which involves all the molecules present in that system. Okay, suppose boiling, you have learnt in your lower classes the differences between evaporation and boiling. Evaporation is a bulk phenomenon, boiling is a bulk phenomenon, whereas evaporation is a surface phenomenon. You have learnt in your lower classes, isn't it? So here, boiling means all the molecules which are present in the container, suppose water is made to boil, okay, then all the molecules of water will participate in that process. But in evaporation process, only the molecules which are on the top, isn't it? The molecules which are on the surface will only participate. So boiling is called what? Bulk phenomenon. Okay, now boiling is bulk phenomenon. Whereas evaporation is what? Surface phenomenon. So whatever the bulk phenomenons which are there, okay, so you call them as what? Macroscopic properties. Whereas the properties which deals with each and every atom, ions, okay, and subatomic particles, okay, the changes that happens in such minute particles, okay, the properties, you call them as microscopic. Thermodynamics does not deal with microscopic properties. What changes will occur in electrons? What changes will occur in protons? That all it will not consider. As a whole, change occurred. Okay. And it also deals only with changes occurred during transformation only. Okay, now, not the total energy of the system. Please understand carefully. It does not deal with that only. We are going to learn as third point. Please make a note of all the points. Okay. So, what is the third property? Second property, I think all of you have understood. It always deals with bulk properties only. Okay, now one boiling process is happening. Okay, there also exchange of energy happens. There also. Okay, then all the molecules as a whole participates. Then how much energy exchange happened? It will deal with that. Okay, how much energy exchange happened with one electron, with one proton, or with one ion? It will not deal with microscopic properties. No. As a whole, how much energy exchange happened? It deals with that. Okay, so that is only second property. And third property is what? Thermodynamics does not concern about total energy of the system. We don't want how much energy is there, total energy how much is there in the system, or during any process how much is the total energy. No, it deals with what? How much exchange of energy happened? How much energy exchanged? Okay, it deals with only that. What is the total energy of the system? It is not dealing with that. How much energy exchanged during any transformation? Okay, so it is not concerned, does not concern about total energy of the system. Okay, it deals only with exchanged energy. Exchanged energy only. Okay, now it deals only with exchanged energy only. Okay, now exchanged energy. Okay, during any transformation. How much energy exchanged during any transformation or during any interconversion? How much energy exchanged? That exchange will take place either in the form of heat or in the form of work or in the form of radiation. Okay, so this is what the introduction for thermodynamics. Once again, I repeat all the points. Thermodynamics is a branch of physical chemistry which deals with what? Which deals with energy changes that happens during any chemical process. Okay, it deals with the feasibility of the reaction. It deals with the spontaneity of the reaction. It deals with whether the reaction can happen or not. That only, in other words, feasibility. Okay, if the reaction happens, at what concentrations the equilibriums will be established, and when the equilibrium is established, how much energy exchange will take place. It deals with only that points. Okay, right. What it does not deal with? It does not deal with rates of reactions. No, because rates of reactions we will study under kinetics, not under thermodynamics, right? It always deals with only bulk properties, that means macroscopic properties, but not with microscopic properties. Please remember, it does not concern about the total energy of the process. It don't want total energy. Okay, it deals only with the exchanged energy during any transformation. How much energy exchanged? Liquid convert to gas or solid convert to liquid. During that transformation, how much energy exchanged? Thermodynamics deals with only that. Okay, but not the total energy of the system. Right? So, this is the introduction for thermodynamics. Okay, so in the next video, we'll learn about the terms used in thermodynamics. Okay, until then, keep learning. Okay, thanks for watching, and your hard work is your superpower. Bye.